This episode was proudly made possible by the all-new 2015 Subaru Legacy. It's not just a sedan, it's a Subaru.
Ebola has been making headlines lately, and if the hype is to be believed, we're all already dead. But if you're just mostly dead and want to know more, here are some common misconceptions about Ebola clarified. Hello, germaphobes out there. I'm Julian with DNews, and I have some info that might help you sleep a little better. First, let's douse the flames of panic and clear up that Ebola has not become airborne. It's adapted to survive and thrive in bodily fluids, and some pretty radical and unlikely things would have to happen for it to change its mode of transportation. It would need to develop proteins that could attach to the upper respiratory pathway, and its lipid membrane means it doesn't survive out of fluids. Because it's already doing just fine with its current mode of transmission, it doesn't have the need to evolve. So if you find yourself around Ebola patients, take comfort that at least the air you breathe isn't trying to kill you. These limitations help put another Ebola worry to rest. Industrialized nations are going to be able to stop the virus's spread much more effectively than the West African nations that have been hit. Knowing how the virus spreads means that we also know how not to spread it. Avoiding bodily fluids of the infected goes a long way, and casual contact with them isn't really enough to spread it. That also means a panic over a global pandemic is ill-founded. Ebola kills pretty quickly and has up to a 90% mortality rate, though thanks to the efforts of the humanitarian workers, it's closer to 50% in West Africa. Those horrible attributes are what makes the disease so scary, but it also means Ebola doesn't become as widespread as it otherwise could. That's right, Ebola could be worse if it actually killed more slowly. Hooray. The last misconception I'd like to clear up is that the outbreak is on the decline. While the industrialized world probably won't feel the effects of it, people in West Africa are still suffering. Dr. Australia Lacery, a tropical medicine advisor for Doctors Without Borders, has called the international response slow and weak, with China and Cuba the only governments that have sent aid. China has sent 115 workers with a mobile lab and another 59 pledged, while Cuba's 165 workers are scheduled to get there by early October. President Obama added the United States to that list on September 16th with a plan that projected to cost $763 million over 6 months, and it's still likely not enough to contain the outbreak. More workers and beds are needed to treat the sick, and earning the public's trust so people can be educated about Ebola is crucial to stopping its spread. How are you getting involved to make the world a better place? Have you volunteered or gotten involved with the fight against Ebola? If you don't have a story to share, I urge you to check out doctorswithoutborders.org to donate. Stay healthy, and I'll see you next time on DNews.